And honestly, what a deck Petros has brought here. It is Earth Machine. Who would have thought that? Tom, aren't you a little bit surprised by that deck?
I am shocked. I mean, no one would have guessed that there would be a 100% representation of Earth Machine from the Cypriot players at this tournament.
He's the only player traveling here from Cyprus.
Statistics.
Petros
exactly.
is insane. And then he just goes top card. It's crazy.
So here we see the Machine of Gearframe, probably a card that maybe players who have been playing for a long time will recognize. Maybe people who have been playing the Time Wizard formats will recognize because it's quite popular.
Yeah, those are old cards there.
Seeing a Machine of Fortress and a Machina Gearframe.
And also the Machina Unclasper was just searched out there and immediately being special summoned out to use its own effect, and then also the Fortress was dumped to the graveyard.
Yeah, very powerful card, Unclasper. When it's added to your hand, then you can special summon it, and then when it's special summoned, you can send a Machina card from your deck to the graveyard.
Yeah, absolutely.
And that was the one.
little correction there.
I totally love how Petros is from Cyprus, and then on the other end, Bostian is from Slovenia. So these are really small countries in terms of Yu-Gi-Oh! Representation, but still they're here in top 64, battling it out versus the big nations, battling out versus all the Germans, all the Italians, all the UK folks, and also, of course, the French players, because those are our most represented players in Top Cut, but they're going as strong here. From now on, it doesn't matter whether you were first or 64th after Swiss. Yeah. Every single one of those can take it. They just have to keep on winning.
Yeah, we are seeing the Fortress on the field. Now we're seeing a Platinum Gadget.
Yes,
that is
it
a Platinum
is.
Gadget, allowing you to special summon a Machine Monster from your hand, I think. Might be some more things than that.
And we do go for the Harvester here.
And now we are also in the Infinite Track engine after we have played through every single Machina card in the game, basically.
And of course, we are going to search for a Brutal Dozer. That's the usual procedure because we can now just special summon the Brutal Dozer out from hand by tributing the Goliath we Link summoned, and that will allow us to special summon out another one from the deck.
Do you think maybe we'll see a Tunneler here?
Probably, right?
Nope, I was wrong. Ooh. That's not a Tunneler. What is that?
That is the Trencher.
Yes, that is Trencher indeed. And Trencher, I think, allows you to modify levels if you like.
That must be the case because
you have a graveyard effect there. You have a graveyard effect of Trencher, which you can banish itself to special summon out another Infinity Track monster from your graveyard.
And there we have the Therian King Regulus, probably the best generic Machine monster that we're having in the game right now.
Bestial Magnamood. And is it a good card to banish versus Earth Machines? Yes, there is a Dark Machine, and it is the Machina Ruin Force, and that's a one-off in the deck, and quite frankly, that is a very important card for the deck because it is like one of the crazy interruption cards for the deck.
Oh, this is a really cool interaction here. We see the Therion Kings attaching the Gearframe from the graveyard, and then Gearframe, being a Union monster, can just special summon itself.
That's very cool indeed.
Making use of every single effect of all of those old cards, even. Gearframe used to be such a powerhouse with Solidarity as well.
The structure deck back in the day, right? Yeah. That was just such a... It came into the tournament scene and it immediately was shining. We had that with a couple of other structure decks in the past, but this one was definitely an example too. We're searching for the Ancient Gearbox, which immediately also is going to use its effect to, I think... I saw him grabbing another Trencher there, right?
Another Trencher, like So Gearbox, I think, has to add a monster with either 500 attack or defense. So maybe Trencher satisfies that. I know people commonly were adding Tunneler in their Super Heavy Samurai decks, one of the few targets.
Little bit of a pot of Everest there.
Exactly. Oh, it's a big bit of a...
Yeah, that is actually true.
It's a fully fledged pot of Everest.
And Bostian, he must have felt relieved after making Top Cut because he was one of the players being 9-2, so he might have been on the bubble for a while already. And then you sit down here in top 64 and you play versus Earth Machines. You have no idea what's going on. Your opponent is just non-stop special summoning monsters, putting more and more monsters onto the field, and you only sit there with a Bestial Magnamood so far.
Yeah, you think Bestials, we've mentioned before, like so great banishing your opponent's monsters from their graveyard, but presumably not too many targets against Earth Machines.
The deck name kind of gives it away, right? It's mostly Earth Machines, but not gonna lie, the Ruin Force is really important in the graveyard, so it might actually come up that it's not there anymore. But there's the other really good Machina card that you need in the graveyard.
Fortress.
There is... No, not the Fortress. I mean, the Fortress is being special summoned here, but he did so by discarding the Machina Citadel. And Machina Citadel is really, really strong because this is the one that has a quick effect on the opponent's turn that can just destroy multiple monsters on their side of the field. And look, he's already bringing it out by the Angle Knuckle.
Can it just destroy itself?
Yes, it can. I'm pretty sure it can.
Does it check the attack points in the graveyard then? Must be, right? Of course it must, because otherwise wouldn't even work with any other monster on the field.
Ooh,
as well.
And look at that. We are going to use the continuous spell card, the heavy forward, to equip it to the Dora we also just summoned out.
Dora, I was this thinking Lee before a second.
The biggest cannon in the game. This is absolutely huge. How often do you see a monster with 3,200 attack and 4,000 defense points?
Not very often, and it's pretty unique in the fact that your opponent cannot really do anything about it in terms of monster effects or just card effects in general, because it will make itself unaffected as a quick effect.
That is really strong. Unless you get Kaiju, then you can't really do anything about this. There's one more card that Bastion is running multiples of, I think. And that works a little bit like a Kaiju, I think.
A little bit like a Kaiju.
Absolutely. There's
just dropping hints there.
Free Kurikara Divincanate in the main deck of Bastion. And I mean, at some point, you want to make your Lieber unaffected. So it would definitely play into Kurikara. So a really, really good card in this matchup. And Bastion is like, sure, I will just keep on special summoning my Bestials, and there is another Dark Monster we can take care of.
And that is fantastic of those Bestials, because you can just summon Magna Muta in the end phase, add another Bestial, special summon that one out as well, and then you're just going to start with five cards and two big monsters on the field already.
Yeah,
and
I mean, starting your opponent's turn with like two monsters in play is absolutely crazy.
When it looks like normal summon, Tracer into Synchro Summon level 10 might immediately be accessed to Baron de Fleur. Yeah. Yes! That is such a strong way to start off your turn. After Petros comboed there for quite a while, with only one normal summon, Bastion immediately has one of the best boss monsters on the field.
Do we have any guesses on what the face down is for Petros? Did he add it to his hand or anything like that?
I did not see him add something, but like, guessing, I would assume that it would be the Machina Overdrive, which is the card that is a theme internal, but it's not. It's Urgent Schedule.
Ooh.
And Urgent Schedule gets destroyed here by the Baron de Fleur.
But
I think that triggers the effect, actually. And you can add one level 10 machine monster from your deck to your hand. That's probably not going to do too much here in this particular situation. Because
underrating the big trains.
The thing is, Bastion probably wants to go for a lot of damage this turn here, because he already has a lot of damage on the field.
I don't see how he's going to do any damage through this 4,000 unaffected monster.
How about Kurikara? I mean, I don't
he's
know
got the Kurikara. Yeah, I agree.
Also, okay. Petros will have to activate the card first, so that means he has to force out the effect.
He's already activated it, right? He detached a material.
Yeah, but he did
that
on his
last
own turn, yeah.
Why did he do that on his own turn?
Probably to get the card in the graveyard, I guess.
Ah, maybe.
Yeah,
okay.
I think so. He detached the Citadel, and the Link monster that's still left on the field, the double-headed Angle Knuckler, can just special summon out the card again, so it's good in the graveyard, and I think that is the plan here. So Chaos Space Discard Absorouter, that's just what Dragon Link or Bestial Dragon players are dreaming of at night, because you're not only searching out the White Dragon, but you can also use the Absorouter effect right away to grab yourself another Rocket Card.
Yeah, another Rocket Tracer being added to the hand there, so maybe we'll see another level 10 Synchro hitting the field.
Oh, but first of all, we are going to summon out the White Dragon Wyvern Buster.
And now we can see easy access to Strike a Dragon and then trying to search out the Boot Sector launch so we can just pop off with all those rocket cards, as you guys just assumed.
Yeah, Boot Sector launch gets most of the time you use the effect to special summon a rocket monster from your hand, but it's actually got a bonus effect if your opponent controls more monsters than you, which is currently the case. Then you can special summon rocket monsters from your graveyard up to the different
route.
So he's going to get a free summon out of his graveyard rather than having to use the Tracer in his hand. Because I think he's already got a Tracer in his graveyard, right? That was the
normal summon.
The normal summon.
He did.
I, when people started playing Bestials, that was when Tailament was a really strong deck. People kind of disregarded the Sarenir a bit, right? It was just there for this Vanishing from the Graveyard effect, but now Sarenir has become the wow, Chaos Dragon Levianir hits the field, and that always means trouble. There is one Negate on the side of Petros, which would be the Therion King Regulus, but there is also the Baron de Fleur as well. And so now Petros will have to probably try to activate the Regulus or activate the Dora as well.
Yeah, I don't think Bastion's going to give him a chance to negate it, right? Because you've got that branded regain, so you're going to be able to trigger branded regain as Chain Link 2.
That with Baron, right? Can you negate the Dora effect?
I assume
you should be able to, yeah. You should probably be able to do that. But as Tom just pointed out, that is very, very smart there by Bastion. Yeah. We are chain blocking the effect of Levianir by also triggering the branded regain, and it looks like we are just going to resolve the Levianir, and then I don't think we're going after Vidora anymore now because it is protected now by card effects. We can just go after the Regulus.
I like that. Bastion just having a good old read of Machina Fortress. Very old card, but it does have the effect when it's targeted by a monster effect, I believe.
And when it's destroyed by battle and sent to the graveyard.
But neither of those two things are happening. Nope. Levianir does not target. You get to choose what cards to destroy when the effect resolves.
So he wanted to activate Machina's Citadel there in the graveyard, but that was immediately met by the negation of Baron de Fleur.
Do you think maybe Bastion's not 100% sure what's... I feel like if you knew exactly this Train's deck, you may have chosen to negate the... What's the Super Dreadnought called?
Dora.
Dora with Baron de Fleur, because now I don't see how he's going to force through any damage this turn.
I mean, if he has the Kurikara, then...
Without having exactly Kurikara in his hand, yeah.
But maybe Bastion also is thinking, I can win this on the long run. I don't need to immediately answer out this card right now. It is fine. Now we get to special summon out the Machina Citadel. The thing is, Machina Citadel has 3,000 attack points. Is it destroying everything with less attack points, or is it also equal? Because that is pretty important in this.
Equal.
It is equal. Okay, so we could get rid of the Baron de Fleur and the Levianir.
So basically getting rid of everything. Magnamut was special summoned as well. Now, is there any restriction for that to happen? Because otherwise this would be an entire wipe right here. I think...
It doesn't look like it.
But did the Baron de Fleur get used already earlier?
I think that so this has an effect that summons itself.
Yeah.
And I think the Baron de Fleur was used to negate the effect to summon itself. But then the Knuckler just brought it back anyway, I think is what happened here.
Yeah, to me it looked like that too.
So maybe he's got no way of stopping this Machina Citadel from just wiping the entire field. I mean, that's a huge threatening field, and it's just going to be... Yeah, here it is. It's all gone.
Wow. Oh, boy.
Oh, is this a Link monster that he's summoning?
Wait, yeah, it is all gone because we summoned out the Ball and Dragon. Let's double-check the Machina Citadel. Is there any kind of restriction on it? You have to target one machine monster you control, and then you destroy that, and you destroy all your opponent's monster with attack less than or equal to that. So I don't think there is.
Maybe he just wasn't expecting the Boral End Dragon right here.
Petros was like, I'm fine, we can wait it out, but now there is the Boral End Dragon, and that is definitely a problem. But funnily enough, the Boral End Dragon also is not big enough to run over Vidora.
Yeah. That is true, but maybe there is a way to alter the attack of the Boral End Dragon? I mean, the dragons all have so many different effects that it wouldn't surprise me if one of them said, yeah, push something for 800.
Well, it can't be targeted by monster effects, so that's going to be an extra special challenge.
Maybe
maybe you have a spell.
Boost all the dragons by 800.
Maybe you play United We Stand.
Oh, that would be cool.
So we are negating the Citadel with Boral End. At least it looked like he announced the effect of Boral End, but Petros was thinking, yeah, no, it looks like that is going to resolve. So that Citadel is just sitting there, not really doing anything, and Bastion is just deciding on what to bring back, but I think there's only the Rocket Tracer that he could bring back.
We are not bringing back anything, and now we're just attacking over the Citadel, so I am not sure that this turn went out the way both players wanted it to work out.
I think Petros is kind of fine with it though, right? Because he gets to keep the Dora, which was the boss monster he wanted to have on the field. It goes back to him. The Machina Earth Machine strategy is very repetitive. He can just start doing what he was doing last turn already, once more on this turn. And I do believe he's okay with this. Because usually the end field of the Earth Machine deck is not really what you're focusing on. You're trying to have as much resources as possible so that you're able to repetitively play on every single turn. And then you just outgrind the opponent at some point.
Yeah, look at his hand. He's drawing to six.
Yeah, exactly. It's better than in the first turn even.
Yeah, and he has a Dora.
Yeah. So, but there's still Borderland Dragon on the side of Bostian, which is not to be disregarded.
There we have another Harvester, I suppose.
Yes, Harvester, normal summon, and we are going to use the effect of the train we searched in the last turn, and that is the Derrickrane.
Heavy Train Derrickrane.
What a name.
Wow, another rhyme.
And we are also, I think we used the effect of Borderland there, right?
Yes. No, that's regained.
Oh, it was regained. Yeah, true. That interaction is so strong. You bring back a monster, and that monster just activates to search for another monster in the end phase.
I doubt that Petros runs any rank 12s, but the Harvester says you can target a two monsters, I think itself and another machine you control, and make them both equal to their combined levels. So
is Lieber rank 12?
Lieber is rank 11, actually.
Ah, all right.
That would be very cool, just a hard make a rank 12.
So I think we just preemptively used the Dora effect here.
Maybe it was chained to the Book of Moon.
Ooh.
And then, yeah, so the Dora was chained to the Book of Moon to try and make the Derrickrane unaffected. But then the Borderland negated the Dora.
Fair enough. But before the match, we were saying, yeah, Heavy Forward being able to attach itself to a monster is just like a little extra bonus, which usually doesn't come up. But right away, we see that Petros actually used it quite well, because it gives you an extra turn for Dora protection. And therefore, he could attempt to do that here, and he already took out the negation effect of Borland here.
Is there, do you reckon, another Heavy Forward? I can't see the last card. There's a spell card in his hand. Could be anything.
There are
a bunch of spell cards. It's only one. That is... It is interesting to see, because we are, as you might have noticed already, not too familiar with the lines of the Earth Machine Train deck.
Oh, but look at that. Bostian being able to special summon out the Bestial Baldrake here is huge, because that does not only mean he gets to trigger the regain to get a draw, but also Baldrake on the field is an interruption once more.
Branded regain means that you are heavily competing with the resource game of the Earth Machine deck, because this is basically like a small pot of Everest for one banished monster every turn.
Yeah, it's like kind of not seriously, like both of these decks are like, it's a resource battle, yeah, because both of these decks are super, super good at accumulating resources and keeping them in flow. And therefore, I don't know how long this match is going to take, because they are just going to keep on having resources.
Yeah, I've heard a number of players say that the regained is the best grind game card in the meta right now, the branded regain.
It probably is. I agree.
I mean, you can just recycle both your Collapse Serpent and your Wyvern Burster the entire time if you use Chaos Space once. Now he sent away the Collapse Serpent for the Baldrake effect and added again the Wyvern Burster that he put back with the Chaos Space before. And next turn he can just banish again the Collapse Serpent and then put it back with regain.
But there comes Trencher effect. And look at that. Bostian might have not noticed that there is a graveyard effect for Trencher, because he seems to be kind of surprised. And that will bring back the Harvester from the graveyard. And I think we might be able to now also use the effect of Makina Fortress in the graveyard. Okay. Petros gets his engines going here again. The trains are on track once more.
And that's going to make both of those rank level 9? Is there a rank 9 he can make? It looks like about...
Oh, yeah. That is going to be a rank...
Is Fortress 7 or 8?
Oh, it is a rank 9. And that is going to be the almighty, also powerful Phantom Fortress Enter Blood Near. That is a card that has multiple effects. You can basically decide what you want to go after. Do you go after cards in hand? Do you go after cards on the field? It is very, very flexible.
This card reminds a little bit of Dragon of the Ice Barrier Trishula.
It does. It absolutely does, but it does only do one of the things.
One thing that it doesn't do is target.
So that is indeed correct, yeah.
It looks very much like that Borland Dragon is going to be ended, let's say. There's a bigger ship than Borland around now.
True.
He's used to being the big bad boss monster, but...
Not versus trains.
Not versus trains.
Also, worth paying attention to is that Petros is running Zeus, and I mean, Zeus versus those all the time generating advantage and resource cards on the field, like Branded Regain, could be a good way to do it.
Yeah, but that would mean if you're going for a Zeus line, then you would have, I think, taken a card from the hand, right?
Probably, yeah. Yeah, you're right, because Zeus would have also been out to the Borderlands. That's correct. Oh, but we just overlay the Lieber over our Adora. And Lieber, of course, is an OTK powerhouse as well. So I think this might be a really good way for Petrus to apply a lot of pressure in this turn right here. You can just put it over any of the Gustav cards, right?
I think you have to put it over a sufficiently large machine.
I mean, yeah, pretty. Yeah, it basically is the same at the end of the day.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a
rank
10.
Has to be a rank
10.
So it has. It's going to attack monsters on the field up to the number of materials it has plus one. So it can attack all of the monsters in play.
Oh, that is looking good so far. Now we have the Anger Knuckle as well. We are running over all of these monsters.
Two. Tack, tack, tack. And number three as well.
We're just using the Tracer here. Maybe that's what Bostrom was indicating.
Yeah, getting another monster to the field, destroying probably the Drang Ravine. Yeah, it does not seem like the Drang Ravine has much more purpose after you have sent the Absarouter to the graveyard. Lobelion is also in there, I suppose. So no reason to have that on the field. And now we can summon a Caliber or a Recharger just to protect our life points.
How did the angry boxer come back? The Knuckler.
The angry boxer.
Yeah.
I don't know whether he's down to be called like that, but let me check on how he returned to the field. And it says, if this card is in your graveyard, you can send one card from your hand or field to the graveyard to just special summon back out. Pretty easy.
That's the most convenient way to summon something from the graveyard I've ever heard, to be honest.
Yeah.
Just its own effect, just anything, anywhere, that'll do.
Is the Zeus as well that I was talking about. It only will be able to use its effect once because there are only three materials, but of course it has its own way to get to more materials if Bostian decides to destroy cards on Petra's side of the field.
I'm wondering if Goliath as well can attach, because Zeus is a machine.
It's a light machine though. So
it's a light machine. No, okay. I was wondering if there was more tricks to attach more materials.
And now we are in the end phase, of course. That we know because Bostian is adding dragons from the deck to his hand.
And
of course,
Magnum. Bestia Druidswarm. And honestly, Bestia Druidswarm is such a crazy answer to the Zeus right away. That is very, very scary for Petros.
Zeus is, ever since it came out, one of the best Exceeds monsters that we have ever seen in the game. And maybe this is also why dragons are really good right now, because Zeus plays, they just really can't keep up with the Druids.
It's true.
Do you already, if we are banishing one card now, Cyphered, that is a really smart way. You can add back the Levian
still
here.
In the graveyard, and therefore it would be a way to get it, yes.
The question is now, do you Zeus already? Because now the Regain is going to trigger. I think it's just one draw. So Bostian is really happy about that he didn't... I mean, it's really good that he didn't summon a monster, summon a Bestial to banish something, because otherwise then you could chain the Zeus to the Branded Regain, get rid of two Bestials and the Regain. Now he just got a draw for free, basically.
Yeah, it feels like you can't... I mean, because if you Zeus here, you're then losing the Zeus as well.
Yeah, you would basically nuke your own field and then also just lose the last monster you have left. Yeah. So that doesn't really seem like the way to go. It will be tough to find a correct moment here to use the Zeus effect. I think you just have to wait for quite a while, to be honest.
This is a real battle of the boss monsters here. Are we about to see a Chaos Angel?
Wow. Indeed we are! Chaos Angel being synchro summoned! Bostian, with his Bestial Dragon deck, has so many tricks up his sleeve. That's amazing!
To be fair, one thing that I saw earlier is that the Collapse Serpent is still in the graveyard, so you had to put back the Cyphered with the Regained. But I think this is something you are okay with at this point. You can summon the Chaos Angel basically for free. It doesn't really bother with the Zeus effect, and you can just now use Druids to send away the Zeus and use the Banish effect of Chaos Angel, I suppose.
Yeah, I mean, you can actually decide on whether to banish the Zeus or whether... Because you might much rather want to banish the...
Anger Knuckle.
Yeah, the Anger Knuckle, because as we just saw, that is able to return. And we just... Wait, what did we send with the Druids?
It looked like the set Derekane.
Oh, true. There's Boot Sector Launch, and still we have less monsters on the field than our opponent, so we can use the Boot Sector Launch effect to special summon from the graveyard.
I think that's interesting that he chose the Tracer there, because if I remember correctly, there should still be a Tracer in hand, maybe. So you could have gone for a recharger and then go for something like a Savage Dragon to have a bigger field here. I'm just really impressed right now with how this Dragon Link deck is performing.
Honestly, one just showing...
Also, there's Recharger, right?
It's the true king of the grind game, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure. And I mean, Recharger into Striker Dragon, into summoning back the ball and Dragon also seems quite appealing to me. But he did, for the moment, not decide to do that. But it looks like he still has a very good plan, and that involves special summoning out the Bestial Disparter here from his extra deck.
Just having a quick check if there's any cool monsters he can summon from his opponent's banished pile.
All of those Cyberstorm Axis Synchro monsters are showing why Dragon Link has become, or Bestial Dragon rather, has become so good for this tournament. Because just look at this, those powerhouses here, so much attack, so much grind game, and then just a boss monster that can basically not be outed.
Yeah, for sure. We already had a brief look through the top 64 players, and we saw that there are multiple Dragon Link, Bestial Dragon Link players around, and it might be a very, very strong contender for this tournament, for a deck going to the World Championship.
Stay tuned for the deck breakdown at some point, because there are surprises in there.
100%. And now we are going to special summon out the Borderland Dragon again. And I think we just brought it out with the Disparter, right?
Yeah, it looked like it was being summoned from
the banished
pile.
Oh, and there's still the Livian here we can summon out. That is so much pressure now from Bostian. It's going back and forth and back and forth.
He's got a lot of damage in play, and it looks like it's going to be enough.
And this is just OTK. This is just game on board, Borderland with the Chaos Angel. And Bastian just takes this after Petros started with this Dora on the field that couldn't be outed. What?
Great game. The crowd is cheering already after game one. Yeah. Usually we don't have that because there's some cheering after the entire match because they're celebrating their friend going into the next round of Top Cut or something. But the people already love that game and I can understand why, right?
Yeah, that was great. That was really back and forth. It was really great to see because I think it looked like the Earth Machine's plan was to sort of outgrind the opponent.
Yeah.
But then the Dragon's just showing like they're the king of the grind game at the moment. Yeah, you're not outgrinding me today.
Yeah, so I'm really curious on whether Petros now, because he will be going first again, maybe has additional ways to make his deck a little more fast-paced, a little bit more... Because he can't really go the outgrind approach versus Dragons, as we just saw. So we could just go for quick and easy Gozen match, for example. Is that a way we could approach?
There are many Dark Dragons in this Bestial Dragon
True.
Deck. I agree. That there might be some other dragons that are Wyvern Burster.
There are a couple.
We can shut off Wyvern Burster,
I feel like
guys.
It doesn't the main deck most in the dark, and then when you start looking at the extra deck,
it sort of
shuts you off a little bit. It can be very, very annoying.
For sure. I do agree on that. And also, Drolan Lockbird is a card that is not too... That's not making Dragon players too happy.
No. Like, Drawn Lockbird, Dimension Shift are the real, like, duo of very, very annoying cards that Dragon players don't want to see.
But also, of course, super interesting, Bostian now being confronted with the Earth Machine matchup. What did he decide to bring in there? Of course, also Drawn Lockbird. Drawn Lockbird surprisingly often played in this tournament, I feel like.
Yes, this is not a card that we really expected. No. Because it has fallen out of favor a lot. It sometimes stopped the Kashtiri deck, but it mainly rose in popularity for the national season because of the super heavy samurai strategy that is completely absent from this top cut. I can tell you already, there were some players that tried some crazy combo variants with it, but they all did not succeed. It was too much to lose the Link 1.
Yeah, that's true.
This deck seems very sort of similar to the super heavy samurai. It's a big combo deck. Yeah. It's using all of these Earth Machines, which Super Heavy Samurai
true.
Did
good
as well.
Point. Good
so,
point.
I mean,
back
maybe
to the OGs. Back
maybe,
to the OG yeah. Earth Machines. But yeah, also more going second cards. Bostian has Triple Tactics Frost, Harpy's Feather Duster, and also more Bestials just in case. But they're playing, but they're not playing too well into those Earth Machines we were talking about nonstop. But I saw a friendly fist bump between the two players. That means game number two is ready. Back into the action we go.
Right, game two. Ken Petros, I mean, he had a pretty good start. We have seen him play for a long time in his first turn, but the field that he put up was not sufficient. Oh, he's shaking his head, but that is a good normal summon right here. Oh, and he has the Drawn Lockbird in hand.
I was thinking that. So, some players do just sort of shake their head because they have an almost perfect
But there's also Drawn Lockbird for Bostian. That is huge. Both players opening up the card we were just talking about while they were side decking. The effect of Machina and Klesper will resolve and it will put the Citadel to the graveyard, but I don't know whether we're going to see anything else. Okay, there's a Regulus. That is kind of a nice consolation prize there.
That is true. Regulus can't special summon itself out, though. I don't think it is a Union monster. I will get it up for you guys. And nope, it is
the Citadel, no, I don't believe so.
Also really nice to see Unions back, right?
you're a fan of ABCs?
Big time.
Never seen you play this deck.
Oh, I played it in Liverpool.
Oh, and there's Dargryll no more now. So even if Petros would have put up a big field, it would have been met by the Dargryll no more anyways.
Yes, and if someone is confused that the Regulus just detached the Citadel or put it to the graveyard, he did not negate the Dargryll no more. It is just the case that now the Regulus can't hold an equip card anymore.
Yeah, the monster is being equipped by Regulus' effect. I wonder if it was a gear frame, which can be equipped by its own effect, whether that would fall off. Seems a bit of a technicality, I'm not sure.
Well, that might be a good point, but now we are seeing the Striker Dragon, and we are not even using one of the small Chaos Dragons with the Striker Dragon, so we can't search two cards, we can only search for the Boot Sector launch, and there we have the Drone Lock, but however, we can go for at least one Synchro play, as you can summon from the graveyard now with a Boot Sector launch.
That's true. Not for the first time in this match. That could come up. I think there's Chaos Space in the end of Bastion. So
that's
the
a very annoying draw, yeah.
Is putting in work. Oh, but there's Rocket Calibre being normal summoned. That's a card we haven't seen in Dragon Link decks for a very long time, but it has become popular again lately. It's just an additional level 4 tuner on top of Rocket Tracer. And you already play the free Tracers, and you need more tuners because you have so many level 6 non-tuners with all the bestials, so it makes sense to also include the Calibre.
That's good.
We're
to go
get
for a
two
series.
Monsters back from the graveyard.
Oh, that is
with
huge.
That launch.
I mean, both of them are tuners for the moment, though.
That is true, but you can go for some Link summons. Yeah, there is the Magnemut, which will unfortunately not be able to search a card in the end phase. Because
it can search from the graveyard. It can add from the graveyard.
Right!
We would just need a Bestial in the graveyard at that point. Oh, wait, whoa.
Just
any
dragon.
Any dragon.
Yeah, it's very
easy
to have
huge.
A dragon in the grave. Well, can you activate it now? Is that allowed if you've got no dragons in your graveyard and you can't add from the deck?
Very technical question. I would have no answer to.
I feel like most players just activate it and then say in the end phase, aha, I have a dragon. But sometimes you're not allowed to activate a card if you don't have any possible things to add while you're activating it. But I'm not 100% sure on how this works.
I don't think this is the case for Magnemut, because by the end phase you could have some cards in the graveyard, and some cards also work like that, but I'm also not especially. This is why I'm sitting here and not standing next to the table as a judge.
Exactly.
Ooh, we're using the Tracer, getting out another Rocket Monster from our deck, and it is going to be a recharger. So all the three main deck Rocket Monsters now combined on the field.
How could the Bestial Dragon deck not be the best grind game deck if it has a card that is called Recharger?
Exactly. It's really a card that, knowing sometimes, I think there's the kind of standard combo and you don't use that many of the Rocket Monsters, but knowing all of the Rocket Monsters' kind of effects that you don't typically use can sometimes be really helpful in playing through cards like Drawn Lock Bird, which really restrict your usual options.
And that should be the first Synchro 10.
I think it is going to be Disparta. Yes, because we have used the Tracer effect already, so no Baron.
Yep, it would have only been between the Chaos Angel and the Disparter, and he sides for the Disparter. And Pasty now as well.
Oh, look at this. Oh. This is very cool.
He's constructing himself a way to actually get that Pasty live there. He will be able to now use its effect by special summoning out the Striker Dragon. And now for sure he could definitely activate the effect of Magnemut if he did not already do that.
Yeah, it looks like it's just sort of generating materials maybe to make a... Oh, is this a Chaos Angel? Is Chaos Angel dark or light?
Yes, it is dark indeed.
It's dark, okay.
Chaos Angel is not a dragon though, right? And there's a Pasty on the field.
Oh,
right.
You make a good point. So I don't know what he could synchro summon here.
That is definitely not going to work.
Yeah,
okay. And also immediately Petros thinks the same that I do. And I don't even think there is another level 10 dark monster he could bring out. Yeah, there is none. So...
Unless he runs a second Disparta.
No, he does not. That's what I just checked.
Very unlikely. So, I don't think there's much to make here because you're locked into Darks and Dragons. Can you make...
I think Borderland Dragon will just come down at some point, and that would be a way to clear the rest of the field.
You'd have to lose your
seal.
Your seal or your Disbarter, which you don't really want to do. Maybe you can make an access code after making the triple burst.
We have Dark Roulette already, and you will get rid of the field anyways with the Borreload. Borreload, I miss.
I'm just seeing there is not even access code Chalker in the extra deck. That's a very popular card for Dragon Link players, but instead there's a very new card from Battle of Legends Monstrous Revenge that he's bringing. There's Sky Striker Ace Azalea that he's decided to play. Ooh, there's Urgent Scheduler now. There are finally more monsters on the side of the field from Bosschen, so Pedros could special summon out two Infinity Tracks monsters from his deck.
Was that what was being targeted with Chaos Angel, maybe?
No, it's in the graveyard, so...
Okay, yeah.
Would have gotten banished in the resolve, and now we are discarding Chaos Space for Quad Borrel,
right? Oh yeah, we decided to go for Quad Borrel now, finally. Bringing back the Tracer, also bringing back the Recharger.
I love how Quad Borrel is just basically there to repair if you have made a misstep at some point, because you can just go, okay, I'm just going to link off everything and then I'm going to special summon two monsters that I want to have for a Savage Dragon deck.
Plan B, yeah. It's just Plan B at that point. And as you say, you just go for the Savage Dragon here. So looks like, even though we were thinking Borderland Dragon is the way to go here, we're not even going for that, which is kind of surprising to me, because there are five monsters on the opponent's side of the field, and Borderland Dragon could attack all of them, and therefore it's interesting to me that he decided not to go for that.
Yeah, because you can only run over three monsters. Seal is such a crazy card, but it's just not the perfect dragon in terms of attack and defense.
That is true indeed.
So we see here like the effect of Droll, even though Bastion's made a pretty powerful field. He's got nothing left in his hand.
There's still the Citadel in the graveyard, I just realized. Citadel triggering here when that monster was destroyed, being negated by the Savage.
But there will be a card in hand in the end of the turn, because Magnemut will just add back. There will not be another Bestial, though.
But yeah, just comparing it to like last game when he started his second turn, so it would have been the fourth turn of the game, with about five cards in his hand as opposed to one.
Wow, and I mean, Petros now starts with two level 4 monsters on the field, and in game number 1, we already saw that there is, of course, one of the most powerful rank 4 machine monsters in his extra deck. There's Gigagadex, which could just grab him whatever he likes in terms of machine monsters from his deck. So, interesting that he decided to leave those on the field.
If you're going for Gear Dragon X immediately, then you're opening up to a pretty rough Heretic Seal.
Probably, yeah, you're right. I do agree.
So you think instead you use the Battle Phase? We don't know, I suppose we don't know how valuable the Battle Phase is. Petros might be able to summon some big monsters and maybe use the Battle Phase to attack over maybe the Savage or the Disparter, but the Disparter is very big as
well. We are discussing now about the good old Quad Borrel. Does Quad Borrel limit you to Link 2s for the entire turn, or is it just after you summoned it? Because that would be something very important here. Oh yeah, we are rewinding.
For the rest of the turn.
Did we Link Summon higher than that after?
No, we Synchro Summoned Savage Dragon.
Oh, you can only Link Summon from there on? Does it say only Link Summon?
You cannot special summon Link or Link 2 or lower monsters from the extra deck for the rest of the turn. So you can go for big Link summons and Synchro summons and Exceed summons.
Okay, yeah, I'm a little confused as well. Hopefully the judges will sort it all out.
We are repairing this right... Wow, even after a draw phase of Petros here.
So from the text of it, it says you cannot special summon Link 2 or lower monsters from the extra deck.
But
he didn't summon a Link 2 or lower, did he?
I didn't see any.
Yeah, he just summoned two Synchro monsters. I'm a little confused here.
Maybe the Chaos Angel was the problem at some point. Let me check Tracer again. Maybe we also didn't read the entire text on Quad Borrel, or did you?
Please, guys, double check on the Quad Borrel. Let's also bring the Quad Borrel back onto the card highlight, and let's just together see what the problem with the Quad Borrel could have been.
If it was a Link monster, you could special summon any number of them. Link rating. You can only use this effect of Quad Borrel once. No, I think you can...
No, I don't see what the problem is here. But the table judge has spotted something.
They are way more competent than we are in keeping track of the game, because they're just standing right next to the table, and of course their job is to keep track of the game being in a proper state. And they have caught something there that is worth repairing, that is needed to be repaired, of course, because you can't just be like, yeah, do we repair it or not? If there's something wrong, you got to repair that, and that is what is just going to happen right here.
It's definitely one of the benefits of being in a feature match area, because sometimes if you do this mistake in like a normal tournament match, it can be quite difficult. You just have to between you.
Absolutely, yeah, for sure. So,
we're just being informed that it was the materials. You couldn't make the quad borrow with whatever was made. So what do you need to make quad borrow? Do you need at least a rocket monster?
Yeah, he used Pisty and the Striker Dragon, but you need a rocket monster.
That is true. There was no rocket monster. So Bostian again is left with that field of no rocket monsters. He wanted to go for Chaos Angel earlier on, but that wasn't possible. Now he tried to go for the quad borrow, which also wasn't possible. So honestly, I think at the moment the judges may even be considering to somehow upgrade a penalty, because that was a back-to-back illegal summon in that case, because Chaos Angel wasn't able to be summoned. Then he went for the quad borrow, which also was not able to be summoned. Yeah.
The main
tricky
thing I was going to say is the face down card. So we see we've reset a card, which seems a little bit unfair to Pedros to have to, you know, like have a card that was previously set and Bostian didn't know what it was, and now he knows what it was after they've reset the game state. So it is something that the judges will have to sort out.
Definitely worth discussing for sure. And that is something that the judges are going to take care of. And we're going to take care of the part that we are here for. We're going to talk more about Yu-Gi-Oh! Because as we said earlier, we are of course providing you with a top 64 deck breakdown. But we can already make some wild guesses, because we talked about it earlier in Swiss, what we are thinking, what deck is going to win the tournament. But right before Top Cut started, I told Tom that I have changed my mind. I don't believe anymore that Kashtira is going to be the winning deck of the tournament. And I'm siding with a bunch of the Italians now. I do believe that Flanderese might be flying to Worlds this weekend.
I feel like we're seeing sort of some sort of stages of change going over here.
Yeah.
You know, the Saturday morning, Sebastian's like, why is everybody playing Flanderese? And then Saturday evening, Flanderese is actually not bad. And then Sunday morning, Flanderese best deck.
to be fair, when it comes to choosing winning decks, Basti is a little bit, myself included as well, like a little kid in a supermarket. You know, you see something that is bright and shiny, you're like, this is going to win
this
the event!
Amazing.
This is going to win the event! Every single round, the
also,
opinion changes.
Also, I'm really mad that the Plunder Patrol Runic player didn't make it to Top Cut, because that is now my favorite deck.
By the way, if we're going to do a little throwback here, Ninjas, Busty, have you played the deck once?
Yeah. You just didn't see me play it.
Aha. Uh-huh.
I didn't bring it to regional, but I brought it to my friend's house.
Of course.
And we had some very fun games.
I thought Leo is your friend.
He's not my only friend.
All right.
No, but for real, it's always fun. And of course, it's always super exciting to see those rogue decks perform, to see those people have fun with those decks. And immediately, I'm always caught on fire. I want to do the same. I want to be that ninja guy. I want to be the plunder guy. I mean, who doesn't love to be a pirate? I was a pirate at Carnival back in the day as a kid.
Oh, yeah, pirate. It's a very cool deck. It's a lot of fun.
I'm still kind of a pirate.
a bit of a Captain Carry right there. So also Gold Pride again. But as we have the time right now, I want to mention our giveaway game a little bit, and I just want to say that I'm madly in love with it.
I thought you got my little transition earlier on where I said I was really mad the Plunder player wasn't really in the tournament anymore, but still, you managed to,
didn't
to get
that,
into it.
Honest,
and it looks like the players have picked up their cards, and that must mean that this game was decided with the judge call, and the only outcome I can personally imagine is that the game was won by our player from Cyprus, that it was won by Petros, and therefore
would be
the double illegal summon there of a monster from the extra deck was something that really, really hurt the Dragon Link play, and therefore we have an even score now in this match in top 64.
Yeah, the Chaos Angel would have been really crucial. He would have had to use the, of course, Pisty, because he wants to do stuff, and the Tracer as well, and then he would not be able to go for this additional level 10 Synchro, he would have to find another way to do stuff, but I don't think that there is a way to get another tuner on the field except for the quad barrel effect, and then you can only go for a Savage, and you can't even go for a Link 2 anymore, so you can't put out something like IP Masquerena as well, because quad barrel just forbids that, so he would have just lost this Chaos Angel, which was making such a huge difference, because it was a banish of a monster, and you would run over one more monster. I mean, but honestly, maybe a Boril end play?
Yeah, I think just from the beginning, even though it looks weird to link away your seal, just summoning out that Boril end dragon and hoping that it carries you to victory sound like a pretty good idea
also
to me.
You could have backed it up with other cards. Yeah. Like, you would have had a Savage Dragon, a Disparter, and a Boril end, if I'm not completely mistaken. And that just honestly really sounds like a great feel, especially if you're clearing two more monsters in the process, which could come back to bite you later on.
I do agree. I think that would have been a pretty neat line, but the players now, of course, have to make sure to just get that game out of the system, especially, of course, our Dragon Link player, because he will be the one going first now in game number three. He has to get his head straight again, just performing a regular cool combo of the Bestial Dragon Link deck, and I think he should be good to go in that case, if that happens. But we were talking about a couple of decks still in the tournament, but one more thing that I like to do is bringing attention to the names that are still left in the tournament, because there are a bunch. We already told you, and we're also going to show you later on in the day how our players from Europe qualified for the World Championship. And we are sending three players by playoffs, which are Gabriel Susi, Jonas Koschel, and Dinka Bui. And guess what? They're not only going to Worlds for the qualifier, but they're also still in the main event. All of them are in top 64. Quite crazy to me.
Honestly, I think that probably Dinka Bui might be the best player in the world right now. In Europe, I'm almost set on him being the best player, gotta be honest.
By results, there's no arguing with it, right? Recently, winning the German National Championships, qualifying for World Championships.
Top four in London.
Top four in London.
He doesn't stop. He just also, like, just casually on that side note, topping all the other events. It's not like he doesn't top, though. It's like, when he's not in top four, he's still in top, like, 32, top 64 or something.
And he does that with the craziest decks. Yeah. I think that at one point he played Madolche and topped a YCS where Telemans was really strong, or was that a Naturia version with Vernacils?
Yeah, no, he definitely played Naturia Runic at that event. That was definitely the case. And I think Madolche, you're more thinking of Eugen Hyde, who was bringing that deck back in the day.
I think he also played a Vernacils deck once.
I guess, if you say
we might ask him later on. No confirmation here on
but
that.
But we have to ask some other very urgent questions now, because game three is ready. Players are set to begin this. So one more game for this top 64 match, and it starts now.
Sebastian, was the urgent question a wordplay with urgent schedule?
It was, by accident.
Perfect. Love those. Okay.
So, what do we think of the Earth Machine deck's chances going second? We've seen it go first two times.
Yep, but Urgent Schedule, just from the beginning, is a pretty good card for going second scenarios, right? Because it can special summon out two monsters from the deck. Pretty, pretty big pressure. Because Pedro's is always going to play into a field of monsters. There's no way that Bostian just sets cards to the back row. There will always be monsters. But Bostian opens up strong here with the quick launch into Rocket Tracer, into Striker Dragon.
Quick launch, just an unbelievable card, isn't it? You can use as many as you like per turn. It has pretty much no restrictions. Just get a free dragon to start your engine going.
It cannot attack and it is destroyed in the end.
That is terrible.
That is two restrictions.
What am I going to do with my monster that's going to be destroyed during the end phase and can't attack on my first turn of the game?
Now we are discarding a Cyphered for Chaos Space. This is looking really, really strong. We are already in the rocket engine. We don't need any Romulus shenanigans for that. We can have the Collapse Serpent here as well. Is going to banish the Cyphered, which is not the most ideal target. You would like to have this in the graveyard for later on, but I think Bastion is going to be fine.
Yeah. Also, we are safe from Drolan Lockbird now. That Drolan Lockbird would have already come down, so Bastion will be free to play on here.
Bastion has one himself. Did you know that?
Oh, that's pretty huge for reserve machines, of course. Also, pretty interesting, we only have a little over 4 minutes left on the clock. And I honestly don't know whether that information is correct, because we lost some time with the judge code, so there might be some potential overtime. So I wouldn't 100% be certain about that.
Yeah, it's always something to keep your eye on, the time, because obviously you don't want to be paying lots of life points or something like that if there's only a minute left.
Totally. So Link 2 is
Romulus
going to be Romulus, of course.
Grabbing my favorite field spell in the game.
Dragon Ravine. So
I guess we're not going to see too many crazy combos this turn because we've already used the Pisty as just a way to get the one of the dragons in the graveyard.
Yeah, he had to do that quite early, and that limits the rest of his turn quite significantly.
So it might just be this Romulus finds its way into a Heretic Seal or something like that. I can't see what else you really want to make with it.
It's already enough pressure onto Bostian and Patros here, but adding a little bit of additional pressure is just me mentioning that the winner, and only the winner of this featured match, will receive a prize card, because there is prize card as prizes for top 32 onwards. So yes, they are in the top cut, but if they want to win a copy of another Verse Dragon, then they will have to win this game right here.
Yes, and the Bestial Lubellion was just sent to the graveyard. This is a card, it has performed throughout the entire weekend. This is a phenomenal card, really elevating the Bestial strategy to the next level. Wasn't as popular when it came out, but by now I think this is one of the best monsters we have in the game.
I do agree. Dragon Ravine makes place for Rocket Tracer. No, of course not. It is going to be Boot Sector launch, but that is going to bring out the Tracer.
We don't yet have any monsters that can just be field spells. We have a lot of monsters that can be normal spells, pendulum spells, but field spells may be something in the future.
Oh, and look at that. We will not be able to end on seals here because Bostian decides to use the effect of Tracer here, bringing out Rocket Recharger, locking him into dark monsters for the rest of the turn. And that's huge because seals is such a good card, not only as an interruption, but also for follow-up purposes.
Yeah, we look like such a strong start, but at the end of the day, are we just going to be passing on a single bar? Oh,
it's going to be Scarlight. Bostian is very well aware of the time, and he tries to burn some life points here, but there's infinite impermanence by Petros, and he smiles into the camera. Petros likes that.
Yes, and now the Scarlight is tributed for the Bestial Lubellion. Lubellion is going to activate its effect anytime soon. Do we run Branded Beast here?
I think I saw that. Yep, there is Branded Beast in the deck of Bostian. He's one of the Dragon Link players decided to play this, but there's still the possibility to just put that Branded Regained onto the field.
And it feels like it's going to be very difficult to get this Scarlight back. I mean, I guess you can always banish it and make a Bestial Disparter. That's probably the easiest way to find its way back into play.
It is not hard once per turn, so you can just summon it back and activate the effect once
again. That's true.
I'd be very impressed if he could do it this turn. But maybe.
There always is a way. So, Bostian heavily considering whether to normal summon here, and he decides to do so. Rocket Caliber hits the field.
Was that just a... He hasn't used his normal summon yet?
Oh, yeah, I don't think he did. He started off with Quick Launch.
Okay, yeah.
And this looks like it's an absolutely legal quad ball.
Yeah, I was about to say, this time he made
not quite normal perfect. Summon. Got to get it in the right zone.
Oh, and I think this is just going to be Borrowlord Savage Dragon, right? This is Branded Regained, Borrowlord Savage Dragon, and Prey, if you ask me, because that's not too much that he's putting up there.
Oh, wow, it really isn't putting the monsters in defense position. Smart choice here. We are attaching the Quad Borrow Dragon, getting two counters here for the Borrowlord Savage Dragon to borrow counters.
And it's the turn of Patros now. And I mean, Patros himself in his extra deck, of course, has a weapon to deal damage. First of all, Book of Eclipse comes down. So that will immediately trigger the negate of Borrowlord Savage Dragon. Or not, he just lets it happen.
Good night, you sweet dragons. I mean, it makes sense. You're not playing into talents by this. Negating this doesn't do anything for you, and now you're getting two draws in the end phase.
That's true.
If your monsters survive.
And also, if you even get to the end phase, because there is the Super Dreadnought Rail Cannon Gust of Max in the extra deck of Patros, which of course would be able to inflict 2,000 life points damage even in the main phase.
And here we see the players just confirming what the end of time procedures are. They do change in the top cut, obviously, because we can't have a draw in the top 64. So if this was the Swiss portion of the event and both players are equal on life points, then one player would have until the end of the phase. And then once that ends, if the life points were still equal, it would be a draw. But that can't happen here. So I think Petros... Is it go phase by phase or turn by turn until one player is leading in life points? I'm putting you on the spot here.
In the beginning, it's just the same. You check at the end of a phase whether you can find a winner. And if there is no winner at the end of a phase, it is going to be on a turn by turn base. So there is now going to be the activation of a very powerful spell card that we have not seen. It's Machina Redeployment, and that is going to discard one to search out two cards from his deck.
Discards the Ancient Gear Box, which is not a card you want to have in your
opening. There's Droll and Lockbird now from Bostian. So does Petros even have a way to get to that potential Super Dreadnought Rail Cannon Gustav Max? Can he even get there? Citadel into the graveyard.
Yeah, this is a really important turn for Petros.
Urgent schedule coming down! That is huge for Petros! He can special summon out two monsters here. And that is, of course, immediate access to Gustav Max if he wants it.
You have to summon one level 5 or higher and one 4 or lower. So not just yet, but almost there.
I think he can do it. Oh, there's Sarunir now being used.
Sarunir, but it is being used on what? We haven't banished anything. Ah,
it was the regained. Just bringing it back.
Yeah, right. So we are going into the Anger Knuckle as well.
And the Anger Knuckle is going to bring back the Citadel. He's going to go for the rank 10. There is the Gustav Max using its effect, trying to burn for 2,000 life points, and that is going to be successful. Petros is trying to win this game right on the spot with his effect, and there it is. We have Earth Machine in top 32 of the European Championship.
Bastion not too happy about this. How could he? He just got kicked out of the top cut by the Earth Machine Rogue deck. One of the only really hard Rogue decks that we are having in this top 64. And what a performance, even through the draw, showing how strong this Urgent Schedule really is. What a card.
It's just a card. We were just talking about Quick Launch being so strong. Just like, well, you can summon one monster. How about I summon two?
Yeah. Easy peasy. That is double the monsters.
Double one, isn't it? Yeah.
100% more. Wow. Absolutely. But it was kind of funny to see because, first of all, Bostian tried to do his burning technique with the Scarlight. That was stopped by the impermanence of Petros. And then on the other hand, that Gustav Max did resolve for 2,000 damage. I think it would have even been enough if that burn damage by the Scarlight would have happened probably, right?
Yeah, so this is absolutely phenomenal. Scarlight would have been great, but
it would have not been enough if the Gustav Max also would have resolved then, if we would have been in the main phase. So it would have been cool. But we were already teasing it a little bit earlier that we will have a deck breakdown for you available later on. And that time has come now. So let's have a look at the top 64 decks of the tournament. What do we have for that? And the number of Kashtira players is even higher than at the beginning.
This will be about 20 Kashtiras, which is
really
strong.
Yeah, I feel like this is a fairly typical pattern of the deck breakdowns, where you normally see like the main top contenders have all gone up a little bit, and then what's gone down is the other category. So I think the other category was a little bit bigger at the start of the tournament, and now has gone down and lost some of its place to all of the main contenders.
Yeah, but maybe the biggest surprise is the next on the list. It's Bestia Dragon. Of course, we just lost one of those with Bostian here in our featured match. But still, it's going up to the second place in representation is pretty, pretty interesting and pretty impressive to me.
We have seen so many runics dominate the national championships as well. The participation number at the German nationals was crazy. The representation in Top Cut was crazy as well. And now Runic is starting to drop out a little bit.
I think people finally have started to find answers to the Runic decks. They are just playing Dark Hole, they're playing Lightning Storm and all that kind of stuff. They are just having their mass removals, which are really good versus the deck. And as you can see, that hurts the Runic players. Yeah. Nevertheless, Ben Kreuzkamp still first up the Swiss with a Runic strategy.
That is absolutely true. Ben Kreuzkamp, perfect performance this entire season. He hasn't quite gotten the win yet of the really deep run, but I think he was always there on the top cut side of those YCS events. He was there in the playoff yesterday, did not manage to pull through, but first after Swiss is really, really impressive. But what else is really, really impressive? This Earth Machine performance. And now we're going over to Ed for the winner's interview.
Hi guys, yes, I am here with our top 64 winner, Petros, who has just told me while he's topped some regionals and some nationals. This is the first time he's ever been to Euros, and now he's through the top 32. Petros, how are you feeling?
Great, great. I didn't think I'd make it this far, especially with my deck choice, but here we are.
Here we are. Let's talk about that deck choice. So Earth Machine is what we've got here, but basically a lot of people have been calling it Trains. There's a lot of Trains.
Yeah, there's only like two Trains.
Oh, that's enough Trains.
In the name. Oh, and there's some in the extra, obviously, the cannons and all that. Yeah, Trains is also what's been called Mystery Machine. I call it MIT, Machina Infinite Track Train. The reason I chose this deck is I've been playing this deck for like 2 years now. Everyone at Locals is sick of it. And I've been seeing success with it, like Nats, as you said, last year and stuff. So, yeah.
And now at the Euros. That's just how successful this deck's going. Let's talk about the match that you had, because there's so much interaction between these two decks. So the first one, very interactive game. You built a very threatening field, but Bostian managed to play around that. So talk to us about what was happening in that moment, because it looked like you had the upper hand for a while.
So the deck doesn't really end on much. I ended on like a Regulus and a Dora that I just knew would survive till my turn, unless they made access code. But that means I probably will survive. And I had five cards in hand. That's the whole point. So I just survived the turn, and next turn I try to kill. The only reason I couldn't actually kill him on the on my turn back is because I didn't have Ruinforce because of the Bestial's Vanish my Ruinforce. So if Ruinforce was on the field, there it would have been game, considering Levi attacked everything. And also I could negate the Tracer in Battle Phase and half his life points. Yeah, the board is, that's probably the best board you're going to see, minus plus or minus a Hand Trap, or maybe sided in like Gozen match or something. But yeah, that's the board that the deck makes, and it's just, if I get a turn, I'll kill you.
And let's talk about game two, because again, a lot of interaction, but then there was sort of a play issue. So can you talk about what was going on there?
Oh, obviously there's a lot of stress in future matches and stuff, and he incorrectly summoned Chaos Angel under Pisty, which locks into dragons, and Chaos Angel's a fiend, so there was that. And then he made Quad Barrel without using a Rocket Monster. So, yeah, and because it was double warning, it became a game loss. Head Judge Edge over came over and stuff.
So. And so then we go into game three. So this is where it was really coming down to the wire. Bostian tried to burn you for the damage with the Scarlet Red Dragon Archfiend, but you impermed that. Yeah. So that's a really exciting. So that's when you're down to the wire, you're keeping cool, you're having to slam that down. What's going through your head in a moment like that?
Well, I know what Dragon Link does. I know they're going to try to Scarlet me, and I was afraid. So if they have a good enough hand, if you negate the Scarlet, they can summon it back with either PST or this powder and burn and try to burn you again, because there's no once per turn on that card. Thankfully, his hand didn't seem that great. So it was just to get the Scarlet and pray. And then even if it wasn't into time, I could have OTK'd that turn.
Okay.
Maybe not under draw.
Maybe not under draw, no. Because we were then there was a Book of Eclipse from you. Yeah. And then Bostian managed to draw you, but you managed to find the Gustav Max, or in fact, I've been told to say the entire thing of Super Dreadnought Rail Cannon Gustav Max, because yeah, that's a heck of a card name. And you got that 2,000 life points burn, so you were looking for that, you found it. How were you feeling when you managed to find the route to it?
I was still stressed, because I was like, do I just end my main phase? Is this what's happening now? I just turned to the judges and like, what am I supposed to do? Is this time on at the end of main phase? Am I supposed to keep playing? I don't know. And yeah, but Gustav Max is a good card. What's really funny is if we got to that end phase, his monsters would have flipped up, but he wouldn't draw any cards because we're both under draw.
Goodness me. Well, there it is, that Super Dreadnought Rail Cannon. Gustav Max coming in clutch right at the end. Congratulations again, Petros. And something you were telling me before this, that you're from Cyprus,
yes,
but you're the only Cypriot at the Euros.
There's a judge as well.
The only player who's Cypriot. And on top of that, you're now also in the top cards. Basically, Cyprus has 100% representation in the top 32 here at Euros. So any other Cypriot duelists, make sure you guys are here at the next Euros. You're going to have to fight for this kind of spot. Congratulations, mate. Really great job. Hope the rest of the top cut goes well for you. We'll give you some time to sort of mellow out before that top 32 so you can let that stress down. But we're very excited to see what's going to be happening in this top 32. Congratulations to Petros. Guys, don't go anywhere. Loads more coverage, not only from this and our top 32 feature match coming shortly, but also more WQP stuff.